person walking in the room.
Yeah.
It's all over the place. All the time.
And that's the way it is for y'all too. You know, you might not see it the same way, but you know, consider that there's an audience around you, you know, because that's the way it is, you know. Probably around all of you, you have people watching you, spirits watching you.
Yeah.
And other beings too. Not to scare you, but other dimensional beings, extraterrestrials, other things.
Yeah, don't trip on that, because you know, some people would, you know, and they will.
And they are watching, you know. There's aliens and these abilities, like we said earlier in another video, jump in and out of dimensions and visible, invisible, you know, travel anywhere.
Yeah,
we call them with our minds. We called some up the other night. Remember, I called those up.
And I really loved that concept. That concept to me was a trip. Like, that I liked. Like, if I could do something, like, you know, with my head, like, with control powers, I would do that shit.
Well, you can.
Yeah, you know, I would. You know,
and
I would.
You can.
I think, look, one day I'll flood, man. I'll let them do that too. I mean, I always tell people that there's true stories about monks who sat on the mountain, the mountaintops, you know, and they used to float down to the other side, you know, and, you know, I believe it was a Dalai Lama talking about that.
That he saw it happen.
Yeah.
He just saw it himself.
Yeah, I mean, you know, we had
that. Flew from one side of the house, the mountain to another, just picked up his robe and just started flying like a plane or something flying through the air.
You see what I'm saying? No,
the Dalai Lama is not going to lie about anything.
That means, you know, one time I also saw a Hindu on TV, a Hindu man, levitating, you know, and they're sitting there, and it was like a camera had filmed them from the side that shouldn't have been there, you know, and I've never seen the footage again. They probably banned it. They probably got hold of it and said, hell no, y'all aren't showing this, you know, but, because they weren't supposed to have been there. And I tell you what, man, it was really, really cool. Like, you know, there's endless possibilities. You know, I'm just trying to use a little example of how far they can go, you know.
Yeah. And you don't have to do anything. You don't have to. It's not like you have to have an instruction book to do this, and it's not complicated. All it takes is there being no doubts at all. And just like we talked about, the other portal opening up to cross people over and being in two places at once with your mind. Same thing. Just knowing you can float, absolutely knowing that without a doubt, you will. That's what they're doing. Those the Hindu monks, the Buddhist monks doing that.
Interesting stuff. It means to me, like, I would love to learn how to float, materialize in other places when I want to. You know. It's really something that's, to me, it's not that long off anyway where I'll be able to do things like that.
You know,
I got enough time to chill on this earth for a while. But.
Yeah, like you said, that's something to talk about. We got 7 minutes left, on this vid. But, you know, it's like, you know, a lot of times in my life, you know, I've not wanted to be here as a young man, an older man now. You know, I don't like this world. I don't like living here, but I'm here. But I'm trying to make it enjoyable. By it becomes a pleasure when you start teaching and helping people spiritually. It becomes more of a pleasure and less of a job. That's what it is. It's kind of like a job here. We live in these lives, but you know, it's a hassle.
Yeah, the everyday life stuff is a hassle, man.
Yeah.
It's a hassle, man.
It's true. Yeah, that's true.
Yeah. It is. Man, you know, like, even having to go to the grocery store or stuff like that, it's like, gosh, I want to spend my time being a spiritual teacher, you know, or just talking to somebody, helping them out, you know, being there for them, you know. Or that's what I want to be doing, loving people, man, you know. That's what I feel like.
Loving people, yeah. My mind's just like, as he was saying that, like, I just kind of turned and, like, I think I was remote viewing or seeing something psychically, but I was, like, zooming through this, I was up in some projects in D.C., actually in Washington, this appeared in some projects, and this was while this moving down the street, you know, like a camera was on this, and it was moving around the view, and the people moving in and out of buildings, feelings people are feeling. I didn't pick the place, it just appeared to me, you know. Well, it's just, that's something to meditate on. Maybe they need help. I don't know. I'm good at sending remote energy to people. You know, maybe energy needs to be straightened out there. But yet, like, the energy colors are bright and stuff right now. I see it as bright colors right now. I saw it as bright red and pinks through the air. The air was shimmering.
Yeah, yeah.
And in my view, I see the energy that people are putting up. And, like, I think right now in this neighborhood, like, there's a good balance tonight.
Yeah, it's good to have.
Happy balance.
Yeah, it's Saturday. You know?
It's Saturday. People are sitting around. They're laughing, having fun. Maybe it's people aren't about hurting each other tonight or doing crazy things right now.
Hopefully
it's at a good vibe. It's nice balance, you know? I can, I can't explain this, but I just do it. It happens. I can do it by choice, too. I can choose communities, states, whatever, different things, and examine energy output or shift it around with thought. You know, I do it all the time, and to help people, you know, try to, you know, the way we see some of the Buddhist monks that we mentioned before on the other side that are around us all the time, they send healing energy into people when we cross them over. Sometimes it's them, sometimes it's just other spirits that help, but sometimes it's them and other spirits sending indigo light out of their hands.
Mel, yeah, I wanted to mention the little boy. This very sincere little Korean boy, you know, five good knees of Korean, you know.
Good. I see him.
Yeah, he's very serious, and he just stands there. I
don't know. He's young. He's like that tall. He's a little, right? I see a little kid.
Yeah.
Like maybe it's like that, right?
He's very small.
Small.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's like four.
Yeah, that's about his name.
I don't know, but he's very serious. But anyway, I wanted to say that about that.
He's just here listening.
He's here. You know.
We're doing good. It took a minute for us to warm up. Sometimes Jeremy and I, like, it takes our minds have to warm up. It's not our bodies. It's not like we had to exercise our minds. And we do it sometimes by exchanging energy through talking and idea exchange. And before we know it, our minds crank up with ideas and feelings and images and thoughts. That's what's going on as we talk here.
Absolutely.
You know, because we're going to be doing these videos every day. So we were talking earlier, trying to figure out, well, what are we going to talk about every day? And I was like, well, maybe we just have to just go with it, warm our minds up and see what we think about after we warm up.
Yeah.
And then ideas come.
We get going and then it's like,
we don't want to stop one thing after another.
Yeah, it's really funny, man.
I'm feeling good now. I felt a burst of energy just pour into me. It lifted me up almost like a happy energy.
Yeah.
Like
I think it's well, but my energy is good, too. You know,
and it just builds on this.
Yeah, but we're getting back and forth on each other, so.
Yeah. Right. That's what we do. That's what we do when we warm up, and it's that energy exchange. I think we're right at 20 minutes, 18:45. We're close.
Let's wrap it up
here for now. All right. Well, I feel another video coming on, so we got a little time.
Don't worry.
All right. I'll see you in a little while.
Yeah.